Hey guys, welcome. See, in this video we'll be discussing the part 4 of day 2. Okay, it is part 4 of day 2 and this is Sociology Options 75 Days Online Course for 2018 Civil Service Exam. And let us see what we'll be discussing in this part 4. See, in this part 4 we'll be discussing the relationship of sociology with political science. Okay, actually political science now is very closely related to sociology, and let us see point wise. First, political science studies the state, the organs of state, the concept of power, its exercises, distribution and consequences. Okay, it also studies about the political parties, political process and so on. Okay, see, if you see all these things like power, exercise of power, political parties, okay, political processes, we can say that the politics is all about influence and influential. Okay, that's what Harold Laswell tells. Okay, Harold Laswell. Okay, Harold Laswell also tells that politics is all about the influence and influential. We may say that it is all about the power and powerful. I'll repeat. Harold Laswell also tells that the politics is all about the influence as well as influential. We may also tells that the politics is all about the power and powerful. Okay, that's the first point. And sociology has a wider focus on the society as a whole within which the state is located. Okay, see, if you take state, we can tell it as political science. Okay, see, political science always talks about the government. Okay, that means state. Okay, state means, okay, for government we'll be calling as state also. Okay, state is always a political science concept. Okay, but what is sociology then? See, sociology, no, it is wider than state actually. Sociology studies state just as a subject. That means state is included within sociology. That means political science is narrower in its concept, whereas sociology is wider than political science. Okay, that is what I am trying to say here. Okay, and that is what they have told here. Sociology has a wider scope on the society as a whole within which the state is located. Okay, state is a political science concept. And the next point, till about the post Second World War, the two disciplines proceeded independently. Okay, post Second World War. Okay, political science and sociology, okay, they do not actually combined and they proceeded independently as their own disciplines. Okay, only after the application of behavioral sciences the two sciences have come together. Only after applying the behavioral sciences. But anyway, certain exceptions were there where the two disciplines actually combined. Okay, only certain exceptions. Okay, we can take exceptions like Max Weber. Max Weber used to combine this political science and sociology. Okay, this Max Weber, no, he wrote extensively on social dimensions of power. Max Weber also wrote extensively on concept of authority. Max Weber also wrote on the concept of legitimacy. Okay, social dimensions of power, authority and legitimacy was worked by Marx, where there was combination of political science as well as sociology. Okay, only this exception about Max Weber. Okay, apart from that, both of them proceeded independently. Okay, only after the application of behavioral approaches, the two sciences actually came with close resemblance. Okay, and we can also see that the behavioralism also has directed the attention of political science on political processes. Okay, here now the sociological concepts and insights are made use of extensively in behavioralism. Okay, see, I will explain again. The behavioralism has directed the attention of political science and political processes, where the sociology concepts and insights are made use extensively in behavioralism. Okay, definitely in political processes, sociology, the concept of sociology is needed. Okay, in political process, like example, voting behavior, definitely sociology is needed. Social basis of parties, yes, no, CPM, Communist Party is there, okay, different kind of parties are there, right wing, left wing, definitely it's a sociological concepts, life, left wing, right wing, what is the meaning of that? Left and right, okay, all these are the sociological concepts in political parties. Pressure groups, definitely pressure group and interest groups, we can also tell as interest group, anyway, both are different, but anonymously we can tell them pressure or interest group, okay, the very part of the sociology, okay. We will also be studying about this interest and pressure groups in a stratification slot, okay. It's a bigger concept, we'll be studying there. Then about the leaders, okay, political leaders, definitely sociology is very important, and socio-cultural determinants of political participations, okay, how the peoples are participating, what is the amount of voting rates, okay, political socialization, okay, all these are the behavior of political processes where the concept of sociology is very much relevant to understand. Okay, and next point. So the political science has broken down the strict academic barrier between politics and sociology. Okay, here the distinction between the sociology and political analysis is not maintainable. Okay, see, actually the political science and sociology was studied separately, but due to the emergence of political sociology, okay, see, we will also be studying in sociology the political sociology slot, which I will be starting. Okay, see, political sociology, you know, it has actually narrowed their independence. Okay, political sociology and sociology is combined and studied in political sociology. Okay, so a distinction between sociology and political science is not maintained here when it comes to political sociology as a subject. Okay, areas like political modernization, political socialization, concept of elites, collective decision making, okay, all these are the areas of political sociology which is borrowed from both the discipline. Okay, these are borrowed from sociology as well as these are borrowed from political science. I'll repeat again those areas: political modernization, political socialization, concept of elites, collective decision making. These are the areas where the borrowing is there from both the disciplines. Okay, and the study of formal political systems, institutions, political theory, comparative government, all are exclusively for political science. Here sociology will not come to play. Okay, political theory, comparative government, okay, comparative politics, we can call it as comparative government, political theory, and the political institutions, okay, all these areas, no, political, the sociology does not overlap much. Okay, it is exclusively for political science, these areas. Also, political science, now it extensively uses opinion polls, statistical analysis, and studies on elections as compared to sociology. See, sociology, no, definitely opinion polls is not a major area in sociology. Statistical analysis, definitely sociology is not concerned with statistical analysis on elections. Okay, they are exclusively for political science. Sociology will not more concerned with all these areas. Okay, that's it guys, that was the relationship between political science and sociology. Now let us talk about the relationship between sociology and psychology, which is very, very important. Okay, and you can see the first relationship, there are two divergent, okay, there are two divergent perspective about their relationship. Okay, two persons have given extreme views. That is known as divergent perspective. Okay? Extreme views two persons have given. The first person, no, it was put forward by the J.S. Mill. Okay, J.S. Mill have given one extreme view, and the second extreme view is given by Emil Durkheim. Okay, when it comes to the relationship between sociology and psychology. Okay, first, no, he tells that the J.S. Mill, no, he tells that science of society cannot be logically developed without taking into account the laws of nature of individual man. Like that J.S. Mill tell. I'll repeat again. Science of society cannot be logically developed without taking into account the laws of nature of individual man. Okay, that means he tells that psychology and sociology, no, they are interrelated. That is what he is telling, J.S. Mill. But the second person is there. He tells that Emil Durkheim. Okay, he actually will disagree with J.S. Mill. Another extreme view he will take. Emil Durkheim. Okay, he dismisses the psychological explanation of social behavior. Whatever this guy J.S. Mill is telling, no, it is not correct like that. The Milder Kim is telling. Okay, he says the society is an independent agent and it exists outside and above the individual. That is what the Milder Kim tells. He tells that, okay, society is there, but society and man, they are not related too much. Society is above man, like that. Email Durkheim is telling. I will repeat his sentence again. He tells that society is an independent agent and it exists outside and above the individual. That is the opinion given by Email Durkheim. Definitely, there are two extreme views, no, divergent views actually. Okay, J.S. Mill view, we can put it here, and this guy, Email Durkheim view, we can put it here. Okay, they both are divergent views. And he also argues that social facts, Email Durkheim, he means Email Durkheim, not J.S. Mill. Email Durkheim also argues that social facts and phenomena must be explained in terms of another social fact. Okay, he tells that one social fact should be explained with other social facts. Then only we can call it as social phenomena, according to Email Durkheim. But Marx, let us see what Marx tells. Marx tells that, come on, J.S. Mill. Come on, Email Durkheim. You people are taking extreme views. What is the problem with you? I will take the middle view. Okay, intermediate view, Max Weber takes. Max Weber is very much famous now to taking intermediate views. Okay. See, but Max Weber has taken the intermediate views. Okay. And he, just a minute guys, see. I forgot to explain one point here. He argued that social facts and phenomena must be explained in terms of another social facts. No, for this one, Email Durkheim has given one example. I forgot to tell. Okay, that example. No, he given the example of suicide. Okay, Email Durkheim. No, he has actually he was very pioneer. Okay, he was the first person who actually studied the concept of suicide. Okay, the why suicide takes place. That is what Email Durkheim have studied. Okay, he tells that the social facts and phenomena must be explained in terms of another social fact. Suicide is an example. Okay, he tells that suicide is actually related to the degree of relationship of a man with another. That means the suicide rate is directly proportional to the man's integration in the social system. Okay, I will simplify it again. He tells that a man or a woman, okay, a person, let us take, he will commit suicide only if he is loosely integrated into society. That is what he tells. Okay, and it is proved actually. Okay, whoever person who wants to stay in isolation, they are more prone to suicide. Okay, this example he has given. And Weber, no, as I have told that, he tells that, come on, I will take intermediate position. He says that sociology and psychology, no, they actually complement one another. They are not extreme views. They are not divergent views. They complement one another. Whatever explanation you were giving in psychology, actually some kind of relevance will be there for sociology. And whatever explanation you were giving in sociology, some kind of relevance will be there in psychology. Okay. He will not tell that simply telling certain kind of jokes here. Okay, he tells that I will give examples and then I will prove. That's what he tells. He gives example actually. Okay, Max Weber, no, he tells that the example, let us give the example of deviant behavior. According to Marx, Marx tells that deviant behavior takes into account socio-cultural factors leading to deviation, also personality of the deviant. Both of this it takes. See, deviance is a behavior. I will explain you people. Deviance. Okay, this concept also you will be studying in the thinkers section. Okay, deviance concept. Let me explain you the concept of deviance. See, deviance is a deviant behavior. Deviant means if a person, that means not obeying the social order, that is known as deviant behavior. Okay, in a road, if there is certain traffic rule, this guy is going in opposite rule, that is known as deviant behavior. That means not approved behavior, that is known as a deviant behavior. Okay, he tells that, Max Weber tells that the deviant behavior, no, it is also sociological point of view. Sociology means definitely the deviant behavior is a result of socio-cultural factors. That means what type of society he or she has come, what kind of cultural things they follow, that is also partly related, 50%. And 50% is the individual personality, whether he is a good man, whether he is a bad man, okay, that is also 50%. Society 50%, personality 50%, combined thing gives the concept of deviance. Okay, example given by Max Weber, where he tells both of them complement each other. Okay, very good example, deviance. And the next point, the focus of psychology, you know, it is more on individual personality, biological determinants and abnormal behavior. You take psychology. Psychology always talks about certain kind of techniques. Psychology always talks about certain kind of abnormal behavior, what the human being is having. Why he is having such an abnormal behavior? What are the actually, why? Okay, what is the biological determinants of this behavior? Does this abnormal behavior is due to the certain kind of genetical mistake in the genetical makeup? Okay, so what is the DNA structure? Okay, this is the kind of research the psychology people will do. Okay, actually, they conduct experiment in certain branches of their own. This is psychological people. Okay, they conduct experiment, no, clinical applications are there, psychological clinical applications, where they will study the human individual personality, abnormal behavior and all, no, they will study in clinical applications of psychology. Okay, clinical application, you can give example of psychiatric. Okay, psychiatric hospitals are there, okay, where the individual personality, abnormal behavior, they will check actually and they will treat it. Okay, clinical psychology is there, and also counseling is there. Counseling means by talking orally and removing his abnormal behavior, okay, something like that. Okay, all these are the branches of psychology. Okay, psychology morely focuses on these aspects. However, psychologists accept that personality cannot be understood in isolation from socio-cultural factor. Yes, because psychologists know, while doing experimentation, he will first ask about the background of a person to whom he is doing experiment. Okay, if he is doing certain kind of counseling, let us take, if he is doing certain kind of counseling, first he will ask the socio-cultural background of a person, from where he comes, from which culture he belongs. Okay, what is his actually socio-dimensional makeup, mind makeup. Okay, first they will see that one. Okay, nowadays they accept that, psychologists accept, definitely there will be socio-cultural factors also influencing the human being. Okay, and sociology and psychology come together in social psychology. Okay, social psychology is a branch of sociology where both sociology as well as psychology come together. Okay, actually they cover up these smaller areas like motivation, definitely in social psychology motivation concept is there, perception, motivation concept is there, learning process, motivation concept is there, then small group dynamics. Small group dynamics is also shared by both of them. Okay, cognition. Okay, all these are the areas where both sociology and psychology come together. Okay, another area of study for cooperation between two is, cooperation between two means cooperation between sociology and psychology, is understanding of certain types of abnormal behavior peculiar to some communities and region. Okay, very important this one. Okay, see, if you study the behavior, okay, if you study the behavior of persons who are staying in India, definitely it is not uniform, it is not at all uniform. Okay, see, one argument is that people anywhere, they feel and they actually feel same way. That means if the people is residing in United States of America, USA, okay, if you go and actually beat that person, that person definitely, he will actually, he will not feel bad if somebody beats him. Definitely if you go to some Tamil Nadu, okay, which is there in India, let us, okay, consider some person, if you beat some other person here, definitely he will feel bad. Okay, that means feeling bad is a universal phenomena, human behavior is a universal phenomena, what I am trying to tell. If you beat somebody in Tamil Nadu, he will also definitely don't like it. If you beat the same or another person in USA, another person in USA, he will also not feel bad. That means human being knows certain kind of a universal psychic relationship is there. Human being, everywhere human being feels the same. If he eats a sweet, definitely he will enjoy in India also. If he eat a sweet, definitely he will enjoy in Dubai also. Okay, so here we are not talking about that broader kind of relationship. Okay, certain kind of minor abnormalities we can see if you judge the people. Okay, let us take India. If you go to India and if you do experimentation, you can find certain variations in certain communities. Okay, certain variations, abnormal behavior you can definitely find. Okay, one example we can give, the strange behaviors of some women in parts of Telangana. Okay, some community, okay, in who were living in the Telangana. Just a moment, guys. Okay, let us take an example. Some community who were living in Telangana. Okay, actually they were having certain kind of strange behavior. Some women know. They were behaving very strangely, and this was very well explained by the social psychologist. Okay, they tell that this kind of strange behavior, no, it is definitely due to the premenstrual tensions what these people were having, coupled with exaggerated fear and lack of proper appreciation of bodily changes during this premenstrual cycle and all. Okay, why this women were having strange behavior means due to many factors like tension in premenstrual tension, okay, exaggerated fear during that period, and also not adequate appreciation for them, bodily changes appreciation, all this caused for their abnormal behavior. Okay, that studies they have done, social psychologist, okay, where both sociology and psychology combined. That's it. Now let us study the relationship of sociology with history. First, let us see the differences between the history and sociology. Okay, the first one. History seeks to explain the sequence in which the events happened. But sociology is concerned with the relationship between the events. Okay, that's the main difference. Okay, history is concerned with the sequence of events. But sociology concerned with the sociology is concerned with the relationship between the events. Okay, that is the first difference. The second difference, history restricts themselves to the study of past, whereas sociology is interested more in contemporary society. That means today's society, sociology is very much concerned with. Second difference. The third difference, history only presents how things actually happened, but do not explain the causes properly. Okay, in history now they will tell that, come on, this event happened this time, this war happened this time, he was the king of that dynasty, okay, this dynasty, and what was the causes of the event. Okay, properly they will not explain, they will explain causes but not in a actual proper form. Okay, only fact oriented causes they will explain. Okay, but sociology is more concerned with the interrelationship between the events, and they will explore the causes for the events. Sociology, interrelationship between events, why this happened, why first war happened, why second war happened, what are the differences between first world war and second world war. Okay, why actually, what causes, what were the socio-cultural problems which actually came together to happen this kind of war. That is what the sociology is concerned with. I'll repeat again, sociology is interested in interrelationship between the events, and it also explores the causes of those events, whereas history only presents how things actually happened but do not explain causes properly. Okay, and the fourth difference between history and sociology is history presents concrete details, but a sociology is interested in generalization and abstraction. Okay, history presents concrete means exact fact oriented details history will present, but sociology, no, fact oriented details sociology will not present. Actually, it will generalize sociology, everything we generalize in sociology, and also it is certain kind of ambiguous thing. Okay, abstraction will be there. That is not clear. Sociology. Okay, the subject is like that. But history, 100% fact-oriented thing. Okay, and now let's discuss the similarities. See, when it comes to similarities, sociology enriches history with an understanding of social history and socio-cultural context in which the events takes place in a period. Okay, definitely sociology, you know, it will actually complement, which it will actually enrich the history with understanding of socio-cultural context in which the events happened. There, sociology contributes to the history. Okay, examples we can take Max Weber's study of capitalism in Germany. I told no, capitalism, the Protestant ethics and the growth of capitalism in Germany, that example. One example, very good example for this. Second example, we can give Indian example like A.R. Desai. A.R. Desai is a social background of Indian nationalism is the best example of this one, where sociology enriches history. Here the size social background of Indian nationalism. Okay, this will be explaining in detail in thinkers section. Here the size concept. First similarity, and the second similarity, a special branch of sociology. You know, it is emerged, that is known as historical sociology, which has emerged welding in two disciplines. Okay, historical sociology is a special branch of. Just a moment, guys. Historical sociology is a special branch of sociology which is emerged where the two fields, sociology and history, combine to explain the things. Okay, and also for understanding any social institutions and culture in general, some knowledge of history is a must. Okay, see, sociology cannot be studied in isolation. Excluding history. Okay, if you know history only, we can compare anything. If you know history only, we can tell why these things are happening today. If you know past only, the present we can understand. No. Okay, example, stratification. No, definitely stratification can be understood only if we have certain kind of historical perspective. Okay, stratification. Okay, stratification is a bigger slot in sociology, which we'll be discussing a separate slot. The meaning of stratification is inequality. That is what the meaning of stratification. Inequality. Definitely, the present inequality, what is there in our country? No, definitely this present inequality, we cannot study 10 years. If we take past 10 years, how can we tell the inequalities? Why people are rich? Why people are poor? We cannot tell actually. We have to see the historical perspective. Right from ancient India, right from medieval India, right from modern India. Okay, after the British rule, what happened? Okay, how was the caste system in British rule? How was the caste system in the ancient India? How was the caste system in medieval India? Okay, how did caste system contributed for the emergence of elites? Okay, how did religion contributed for the emergence of political parties in India? Okay, how did these political parties actually benefited the dominant caste people? Okay, all these things, caste means definitely inequalities will be there. Caste, okay, religion concept, inequalities definitely there are. Okay, to study this kind of caste related, religion related inequalities, definitely we should see history. Why certain community is forward today? Definitely we have to see history. Why certain community is backward today? We have to see history. We cannot understand by seeing just 10 years back. We have to see right from the ancient period till we are now. Okay, that's where the sociology and the history combines together to explain things. Okay, that's it, guys. This was the end of day 2, part 4. Okay, end of day 2, part 4. And let's meet with the next video, that is day 3, part 1. Okay, that will be in the next video. Till then, bye.